Next, we're going to dig into taking an idea or a topic that you have that you think you'd like to become a systematic review and really doing the work of taking that and formulating a very clear and answerable research question. And I want to stress that this is pretty fundamental, and you shouldn't underestimate the amount of time you might want to spend at the very beginning thinking through your question, maybe multiple times, until it feels just right. Because sometimes people ask a question without thinking it through that well, do a bunch of work, do some searching, start doing some screening, and realize their question didn't really align with the research that's out there or the way they would like to apply their systematic review. So doing the work in the beginning of getting your question right is time well spent. So as I said, these questions are key to the quality of your review. They determine the type of review or synthesis you're going to do. Is it really a systematic review question? Is this really an umbrella review question? Is this really something that I should be doing more of a traditional lit review for? Questions can help you determine that. They determine the viability of your study. If your question's too narrow, there may not be enough literature to synthesize. If your question is too broad, perhaps you won't be able to apply your findings in the way, in the context you'd hope to. Your questions can help set up your inclusion criteria, which studies match my research question and I synthesize, and which are now out of the scope. Can I not include because they didn't align? And along with that will inform the kind of data you'll extract from the included studies. They will guide the research strategy you use, the search strategy once you get into the databases, and ultimately it will impact how you can really apply the findings of your study. So there are several elements of a good question, and this isn't firm. This comes from the Campbell collaboration, which is the social science element of Cochrane, which is kind of the gold standard for doing systematic reviews. And they encourage folks to walk through, ask yourself these questions as you're setting things up. Is it specific? Is it too general for a systematic review? Is it answerable? Can I really answer the question with the data that would be included in these studies? Does it use measurable constructs? Are these things where the data is available, or is much of the literature out there right now more theoretical, where the work of bringing it together wouldn't necessarily be in the data? Is it practical? Is there a real need for this? Is it relevant to the people in my field? Can it inform policy or practice? On a really basic level, is it logical? Does it make sense? Am I asking the right question here? Or is the heart of the question just next to that? And finally, this is, I think, probably the most fundamental. Is it empirical? The whole idea in a systematic review is to take that review process, that literature review, and make it more valid, make it more replicable, and connect it to findings rather than just ideas. So the whole goal is to have an empirical approach to synthesizing literature.